So Babak, in your article, you point out that agents is a useful way to understand AI. How is the previous way of doing that different from what we have today?
In the past, we were forced to view AI as agents because we were forced to simplify the domain in which they operated because AI wasn't as powerful. And so in a simplified problem, it would be able to operate much better and more effective. Today, the issue is the other way around. Like our agents, our large language models are very, very powerful and robust, and we have to limit them to take a persona that's useful within a workflow.
Now, so does it apply also for multi-agent systems? Because that was a big thing in the past.
It does, and even today we are basically automating workflows, and in order to do that, we do need to take these different personas. It's easier in some ways because we can use natural language in the way these agents can communicate with each other and the way we set them up. So there are things to go for multi-agent systems today because of the power of LLMs that we did not have in the past.
Now, you make an interesting distinction between knowledge retrieval systems and knowledge workers. Can you expand on that? How do we deal knowledge workers differently from retrieval systems?
We give the tools to the agent in order to then, when we interrogate it, be able to respond to us. And that's a much more reliable way of using large language models in the form of agents. If we rely on the large language model's world model and what they've trained in the past, they can make things up, they're generative, and they might actually not have the latest and greatest data as well because they are pre-trained. So treating them as knowledge workers is much better than treating them as knowledge retrieval systems.
Yeah, that's interesting that by giving them more freedom, you actually make them more trustworthy.
That's right, and trustworthiness is very, very important for us, especially because we're delegating now human-like behavior to them in our business workflows. Mm.
Now, another important point that you make is that these systems are not trained continuously. You see that as something that's missing from their intelligence.
I do think so. Every time intelligence has evolved in real nature, it has been an online kind of intelligence that learns as it goes. And our pre-trained models do not have that. I do think that's important and it's missing, and we have to kind of dance around that by the way we engineer these agents.
Do you think that it's fixable, or is it something that requires a completely different approach?
I think it does require a different approach because at the heart of these models, we're dealing with systems that have to be trained offline over a lot of data. And I think that we do need another set of breakthroughs to get to a point where we can actually create the same kind of emergent intelligence, but through an online learning model.
And you point out that symbolic systems might be such a solution. How would that work?
That's one example. We know a lot about symbolic systems, and inherent to symbolic systems is the fact that they can reveal the logic by which these models are operating, which can deal with some of the weaknesses, such as the opacity of the generative AI models that we have today.
So if we build such a system, would it be so different that it would constitute a paradigm shift in AI?
I do think so, because dealing with a model that is learning as it goes and changes its world model does require a different way of thinking about these AI models.
Yeah, those are really interesting insights. Thanks, Babak.